Good day, fellas. I hope you are feeling well, and today we are going to have the Q&A video about streaming. So how the things went, we asked your questions on our Instagram account, @baboonparadise, and you came up with thousands of questions, literally. So what we have done, well, actually what Vivi have done, she went through majority of the questions and she picked 20 of them, and today I am going to answer into those questions. And obviously, fellas, I haven't seen those questions myself before, and this is going to be quite a big surprise for me and hopefully interesting for you. Baboon King, what made you to love streaming and how did you start it? As many of you fellas know, in the past I was serving in Lithuanian Navy and my contract was about to expire, and I had a passion for World of Tanks for quite some time. I started playing the game in 2012. So pretty much whenever my contract was about to expire, I was lucky bastard, honestly, because I was playing with someone in platoon. I believe from my old clan Santi, and they said, "Skill, you're a funny guy. Try to stream." And I am through streaming. What the flying F is that? And that's how I figured what streaming is, and so on, so on. And in fact, first streamer which I started watching, I believe it was Orzanel. Anyways, moving to the second question, and hello Skill, how long was it before you could start living out of streaming income? Very, very good question. I can tell you one thing, fellas. Back in my days, Twitch did not drop affiliates left, right, and center, so I needed to have every average 500 people in the stream in order to get subscription button, and pretty much then things changed, because back in my day, I was getting only donations, right? And I am very, very grateful for everything, fellas. I remember first donation goal was microphone. So after that, donation goal was camera, or maybe first donation goal was camera, then it was chair, then it was something else. I can't even remember, but I can tell you one thing. I am here just because of people's generosity. If not you fellas, I wouldn't be there. So it is very hard to answer into this question, sir. It is just simply impossible. Depends on the luck. For example, first 3 months, I had literally no one watching the stream, or 3 to 4 guys sitting in the stream. 3 months, and I was putting a tremendous amount of hours. But after that, you know, you are creating YouTube channel, you are trying to build a community in this way, and that's how the things are going better in a way, right? More people you can reach, in a way better it is. Third question, what your income really depends on, and how it how to change it if needed, without numbers, Huba is asking. Okay, I can tell you one thing. For example, on the YouTube, income depends purely on ads, or you can take the sponsors, and sponsors are paying quite a good money, right? On YouTube, this is how the things are looking like. And on Twitch, there is a couple of source of income, aka donations, right? Bits, which is pretty much donations, but you are getting them later on with a salary. There is subscriptions, aka people are dropping their free Twitch Prime, and streamers are getting money for this, right? Aka tier 1s, tier 2s, tier 3s, pretty much subscription based thing. So I can tell you one thing. If there is no one who are dropping tips or bits or subscribing, then you are not getting anything. And obviously ads, you are getting a bit of the money from ads, but I can tell you that it is not a significant amount, okay? Moving on, next, fourth question, Marines. How hard it is to start up the channel? Couple of buttons and you are starting the channel, easy peasy. To start everything, it is not that hard. To attract people, this is completely different story, and you need to be interesting in your own way. Can you be successful if you are not the greatest player in the World of Tanks? Sure thing. If you have personality, you are going to be very successful. And also in the same page, we have Jerry, who asked, is it worth trying to get into the streaming? I am pretty decent player. If so, any tips how to start? Thanks. just start it. This is the tip. Honestly, you can talk about this for a whole video, how to do the things, at least from my opinion, but I can tell you one thing. First of all, craft the schedule and be consistent and do not expect to make money whatsoever. Look at this as a hobby, and maybe after some time, hobby would become a full-time job. Other than that, I don't really think I have anything to say. Just start it. Also, very important things are you need camera and you need microphone. Those are the two most important things, right? And after that, be yourself. Fifth question. Talon is asking, how you mentally prepare for stream, for example, routine or schedule? I am treating streaming as a job, right? How you are waking up 6 in the morning and preparing for a job or for a school? I am doing literally the same thing. It is my job. It is my schedule. I need to make obviously YouTube videos daily, and I need to stream pretty much daily apart Mondays. That's about it. There is no such a thing as magical recipe. Run around the house 3 times and pump yourself up. There is no such a thing. Job is a job, but I enjoy my job, to be fair with you, most of the time. Obviously, there is some days when I don't really like how the things are looking like, and I can't change anything about this. Anyways, moving on next. Sixth question. How much work outside of what we see is putting into the streaming? Into the streaming, probably not that much. There is messages which we are replying, aka Instagram Baboon Paradise. I am reading comments usually daily in the YouTube videos. I am making YouTube videos overall, and now when we have pretty much 4 channels, well, let's say 3 channels. Baboon Paradise once in a while, right? Daily, Skill4ltu, aka main channel every single day, and Skill4ltu extra once in 2 days. So you pretty much need to work your ass off. And obviously, not everyone knows how much it takes, but I can tell you that it's definitely raw streaming hours is around 160, and after that, there is a lot of other things which I need to do. So I would say, from how much time I work, 250 hours plus for sure. Okay, moving on next. Seventh question, mysterious one, and Luke. Has being a streamer affected your usual schedule, like when you wake up, have breakfast, etc.? And how much does it affect your personal life? Two very similar questions, I see. Honestly, it is like having job, but in my situation, it is evening job or kind of night job. Because I am starting the stream from 6 p.m., to midnight, I can stream longer, but usually I am trying to go for 6 hours, just not to overburn myself, if you know what I mean, and this is very important thing. So, speaking when I am waking up, for example, now I have messed up sleeping schedule and I'm waking up from 12 to 2, literally, p.m., because I'm going to sleep 5-6 in the morning, which is not healthy for me. I understand this, but every single gamer went through this stage, and I am going to fix my sleeping schedule and everything is going to be fine. But other than that, it is simple job, fellas. Okay, eighth question. Patata, have you sacrificed something just to better the... Have you sacrificed something just to better the stream? Or to improve the stream, I suppose to say. Health, go to the dark god, social life. Yes, in a way, yes. You see how the things are looking like. Majority of my friends, mates, whatever, they have completely different schedules. So I don't really have that much time and to go somewhere and so on. Plus, currently the situation of the world is not very great for this. But overall, social life is pretty much zero. Well, luckily, I am lucky, fellas. I found my life love. I am with my girl and we are spending the time together, blah, 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 blah. But overall, to meet someone, it's happening pretty rarely. From time to time, it happens, but not that often whatsoever. So in order to be successful at this, especially when I am, let's say, couple of years into this business, I needed to craft the schedule, and the best schedule, what I noticed, it is from 6 to the midnight, because that's how you are reaching majority of the people by saying this. It is evening in the Europe, it is morning It is afternoon in States, right, in Canada, and in the same time it is morning in the New Zealand or Australia. So pretty much how the things are looking like, you are sacrificing quite a bit. Let's put that in this way. Ninth question. Hugo and Robin is asking, do people in Lithuania want to interview you? okay, I see, like web magazines, radio, TV, or even in the world. Are you afraid of being famous? I mean, when you are going somewhere, are you afraid that you probably will get noticed or something? I see. Okay, let's start from the first question, and yes, I got invited into the web portals, I got invited into the radio, and I said all the time no. Why so? Because I don't want to be famous. I don't want to be known, I want to live my normal life. I don't want people to know who I am or what I am doing. Although, I think I have met 3 or 4 people who recognized me. I remember I met one guy in pizza place, and he stopped, he froze, and he's skill. After that, I met people. One person in the gym. After that, I met one person two guys next to McDonald's. And I met one person somewhere elsewhere, and I cannot tell now where, but it doesn't really matter. So it happens from time to time, and obviously if you are seeing me, don't be afraid to say hi, but I don't want to, you know, I don't want to raise my hands and to say, hey, look at me, what I'm doing. Absolutely not. I don't care about this. Okay, 10th question. Tony and Julius, both of them are asking, do you have more free time than someone who works 9 to 5, 5 days a week? No. Absolutely not. Do you think your life is easy compared to a normal 8 hours work job? Depends. You cannot underestimate any job. For example, before I was working in the Navy, and obviously I was working more than 200 hours. You can't compare those two things. Or for example, you are working somewhere in office. My job is completely different from other jobs, and I can say the same thing about every single job. So is it easy? I don't know. You tell me. You will be my judge. Like I said, I work approximately 250 hours plus in a month. That's about it. You tell me, is it easy or it's not? Moving on, next 11th question. Elsu, what's up, and AK47, both of those gentlemen are asking, do you feel any pressure from the people who say that you earn money in easy way? I'm not one. How dare you? And do you handle criticism and hate from the chat, especially in your younger days? Cheers. Okay, let's start with the money. There is no such a thing as easy money, fellas. I need to work my ass off, and I needed to work my ass off where I am now, in a way, right? It's not like I started streaming and the very first day, oh yes, fellas, yes, please. No, it was completely different conditions, and I remember when I got my very first 5 euros donation, I was screaming like little chickmunk, okay? I was extremely happy, and it was crazy for me how someone could support this person. How? You know, it is the case. Anyways, AK47, how do you handle criticism and hate from the chat, especially in your younger days? I can tell you one thing, it is literally impossible to please 100% of the people. It doesn't matter what I will do. Will I bend over and spread my ass, or would I do whatever people said me to do? It is impossible. So what can I say? My answer is very, very simple. In Twitch, if someone is crossing the line, it is very simple to avoid any controversy. 2 buttons and the person is gone, and you will never see him again unless he is going to create account, and then you will press 2 buttons once again. And overall, I can tell you one thing, I am extremely self-critic for myself. I am not one of those persons who is blaming everyone else apart himself. I am taking responsibility myself. If I am messing up, I'm going to say sorry. If I am playing bad, I am going to say donkey in the chat, right, and motivate me in this way. So I believe I am quite fine with the criticism, honestly. Okay, 12th question. Nay, how are you doing? And does working as a streamer counts as working age? What someday you will be able to get a pension in Lithuania? No. The thing is, I have my company open, so I am, as a company owner, I am paying taxes as a company, and I am paying taxes whenever I am taking money out of the company, but for the pension I need to save. So pretty much whenever I'm going to be 60 years or 70 years, whenever pension is starting, I am not going to say get a single penny from Lithuania. Although there is another option how I can pay more taxes and get pension, but when I did calculations, I would get 150 euros pension, so it's not worth it. It's so much better to save for myself and just simply secure my future in this way. So yeah, so as you can see, fellas, whenever you are working as a streamer, you need to think about future, and I don't know how much I can do this till 13 with 27 years of experience, or till I will be 13 with 37 years of experience. I do not know. So yeah, that's the thing. Okay. Moving to 13th question. How difficult it is to do the taxes? I have a tax as expert, right? What that basically means? That basically means person is... I am paying a salary for a person, and that person is doing taxes for me. I do not understand taxes, and I do not put my fingers where I don't understand. So yeah. 14th question. Can you play variety of the games and still make money? I don't know, but I am not playing other games, and the main reason why I'm not playing other games is because I'm afraid to get a catch for the other game. What that basically means, imagine I'm starting to play Diablo. Doesn't matter, right? Diablo, Path of Exile, Call of Duty, whatever, you name it. And I'm getting catch on that game. And I am turning on tanks, and I am... Yeah, it would be quite a big problem, so I do not play other games, I just don't. I am afraid to get catch, I'm being 100% honest. Do you feel you can only play World of Tanks, or do you think your community would support you? Honestly, if we would move to the other game, it depends on the game obviously, but I think we would lose approximately 80 to 90% of the people base. So I think it is very, very not worth it, and this is just simply a stupid thing to do. Vartspy, what do you like more, streaming or YouTube? Streaming, and I can tell you straight in the face, because whenever you are streaming, you are feeling like you have contact directly with the people. You are seeing chat in the corner, and someone is asking, hey, Skill, how is your day? Or Skill, you suck, but you have like the different... the direct contact. And speaking about the YouTube, you are recording, and then there is some editing to be done, and then you are releasing. Obviously you can go through the comment section, which I do quite often, but in the same time it's not the same. So streaming is what I like to do more, but by any means YouTube is very important part of the job as well. Okay, 16th question. Gandra, how would it affect on stream if when you are going to have kids? This is extremely good question, but I believe it is going to affect stream for sure, because there is going to be a kinder which is running around the room, especially in the early days, and sure it will affect the stream. Also, I think if and when we are going to have a kinders, I believe then I will need to cut stream hours a bit, because you know, family and everything, you need to spend quite a bit of time, or maybe take extra day off and give a break for a mother of the child, right? And to spend a bit time with the child, because it is complicated thing. It is not so simple, you know, boxed and everything is fine. No, you need to spend quite a bit of time, fellas. Moving on, next 17th question. Big Baboon, tell us something about the hard times, negative sides of your job as part of the streamer. Honestly, there is not that many negative aspects as a streamer. Obviously, you have your schedule and you need to be there. Obviously, it could be some exceptions. For example, you need to go to the doctor or whatever, so you can have a bit of the time off. But in the same time, I am trying to keep with a schedule, so it can be annoying, but not so much. I mean, it is a job after all. And obviously you can meet people which are trying to be annoying and which can try to mess your mood or overall calling trolls, you know, which are talking shit about you, whatever, doesn't really matter. So honestly, I can tell you one thing. I do not read forums. I do not read Reddit, you know, outside of our Reddit, which we have. It is just simply not worth it. I know it is impossible to please 100% of the people. And if people don't like me, I mean, don't watch me. Who you think you are, you know? You can bark as much as you want. In other words, answer is very, very simple. If I am not getting constructed criticism, I don't care. If I am getting criticism which I deserve, then I care, and then I am going to make one or another decision to fix the problem which is in me, right? So here you go. Okay, 18 question. Fedo and Nathan, is streaming changed your mentality or the people or the way you see other people? Best regards. Another question would be, what kind of effect does being a streamer have on your mental health, good and bad? Honestly, I think I am relatively strong mentally person. I don't really care, once again, I don't really care about the criticism that much if I do not deserve it, right? For example, when, I don't know, person, imagine that you are playing whatever tank, right? And you are holding position. Skill, you camper, how dare you not to go in front? Or skill, you are shooting gold. Or skill, how dare you to whatever, to outplay him like this. I don't care about those kind of things. I am just doing me, right? So once again, fellas, I can tell you one thing, what you are not seeing, there is plenty of messages which are messaging us from time to time, right? Skill, I have quite a bit of problems in my life, blah, 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 blah. And your stream helps me a lot and so on. And this is the power which keeps me going in front, and I am very, very happy about this. And once again, mentally, I think I am pretty strong. I think I know what I am doing, and everything is completely fine. And obviously, what I know, 99% of the people are amazing and they are golden, and you can put them next to the heart. And other 1% of the people, you are clicking two buttons and you are permanently banning them, so you won't see their face ever again. If you see the person is very, very special, and it is the same thing like speaking with a wall, you know, it is one way to deal with a problem. Moving on, next 19th question. How long do you think you will be able to do this for a living? And Marius is asking your fears about the future and kind of developing of World of Tanks, if that's not too private. Okay, first of all, I can tell you one thing. I do not know how long I will be able to make living from this, but we'll see. I am saving as much money as I physically and possibly can, because once again, I am not getting the pension and everything, so I need to think ahead. So yeah, we'll see how long we can do. So far it is not slowing down, and so far everything is looking great, and we are doing that for pretty much 6 years already. And speaking about the World of Tanks development, you see, if World of Tanks would die one day, World of Tanks would close, I would move to the other game. If World of Tanks would start sinking, I would move to the other game, you know? I would not be like a captain of Titanic. You know, and the ship is sinking. No, who? it wouldn't be the case, fellas. I can tell you one thing. 90% of the streamers would run from the sinking ship. Like, there is no tomorrow. Everyone. I quit World of Tanks. I run away from World of Tanks. I do that. The thing is, as a streamer and as a content creator, YouTuber, whatever, you need to make money. And if interest of the people are going down, if you are becoming irrelevant because the game is becoming irrelevant, you are simply you have two options: either to be happy with the breadcrumbs, or either to make a move somewhere elsewhere to pretty much enjoy yourself, right, and to make money in the same time. Because once again, what you need to understand pretty much, at least in my humble opinion, majority of the streamers are not going to get pension, so they need to save. And you might think, but Skill, you are making a lot of money. Yeah, but whenever you are thinking taxes, 40% or so, pension and everything, and then, no, maybe it's not that much, no, maybe it's not that great. So yeah, here you go, this is the answer to your question. And 20, last question. After deciding to become a streamer, is there any regrets you had about it? Not a single regret, absolutely nothing. I am living my dream life and I am enjoying myself. And I hope, fellas, you are also extremely well entertained, and I hope you are having a great time together with us. So, fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to be part of those kind of videos, remember you can follow us on Insta. You will see the comment in the description or link in the description, or simply Google Baboon Paradise Insta and you will find us very, very easily. I hope you enjoy this kind of videos. You know, fellas, me, I am being honest with you as much as I can be honest, you know, because sometimes when I know something about the game, what is coming, but I have no permission to say, I can't say that. But I can say, tell you one thing, fellas, I'm trying to be as honest as I can, and I hope you appreciate that. So, once again, thank you very much for watching. I hope you had a great time, and I hope you enjoyed yourself, and Skill is out. Peace.